Good morning, everyone. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who teach us that you abide in hearts that are just and true, grant that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. When the Lord saw how great was man's wickedness on earth, and how no desire that his heart conceived was ever anything but evil, he regretted that he had made man on the earth, and his heart was grieved. So the Lord said, I will wipe out from the earth the men whom I have created, and not only the men, but also the beasts, and the creeping things, and the birds of the air. For I am sorry that I made them. But Noah found favor with the Lord. Then the Lord said to Noah, go into the ark, you and all your household, for you alone in this age have I found to be truly just. Of every clean animal, take with you seven pairs, a male and its mate, and of the unclean animals, one pair, a male and its mate. Likewise, of every clean bird of the air, seven pairs, a male and a female, and of all the unclean birds, one pair, a male and a female. Thus you will keep their issue alive over all the earth. 7 days from now I will bring down rain on the earth for 40 days and 40 nights, and so I will wipe out from the surface of the earth every moving creature that I have made. Noah did just as the Lord had commanded him. As soon as the 7 days were over, the waters of the flood came upon the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will bless his people with peace.
The Lord will bless his people with peace.
Give to the Lord, you sons of God. Give to the Lord glory and praise. Give to the Lord the glory due his name. Adore the Lord in holy attire.
The Lord will bless his people with peace.
The voice of the Lord is over the waters, the Lord over vast waters. The voice of the Lord is mighty, the voice of the Lord is majestic.
The Lord will bless his people with peace.
The God of glory thunders, and in his temple all say, glory. The Lord is enthroned above the flood. The Lord is enthroned as king forever.
The Lord will bless his people with peace. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples had forgotten to bring bread, and they had only one loaf with them in the boat. Jesus enjoined them, watch out, guard against the leaven of the Pharisees and the leaven of Herod. They concluded among themselves that it was because they had no bread. When he became aware of this, he said to them, why do you conclude that it is because you have no bread? Do you not yet understand or comprehend? Are your hearts hardened? Do you have eyes and not see, ears and not hear? And do you not remember when I broke the 5 loaves for the 5,000? How many wicker baskets full of fragments you picked up? They answered, 12. When I broke the 7 loaves for the 4,000, how many full baskets of fragments did you pick up? They answered, 7. He said to them, do you still not understand? The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Biblical numbers. When I broke the 5 loaves for the 5,000, how many wicker baskets did you pick up? 12. 12 for the 12 tribes of Israel. When I broke the 7 loaves for the 4,000, how many full baskets of fragments did you pick up? They answered, 7. That mystical number, 7. How many times am I to forgive my neighbor? 70 times 7. The completion of God's plan and God's mission. These numbers are not just by accident. They point us to a greater truth. Tomorrow we'll celebrate the beginning of Lent, and the ashes will point us to a greater reality. And that's the greater reality that we must never forget, of why we come and we do repentance. Ashes are placed on our forehead as a sign of repentance. And that's the greater good. Not just to have the ash, but of what it signifies for us, our mortality. But the cross, our life. So even the cross with the ashes remind us of the Paschal mystery, doesn't it? It's only in dying that we'll rise. It's only when we die to sin will we rise to new life. And the Lord gives us a great opportunity to go onto this beautiful retreat with Him. In my homilies during the weekend, I did not use the word retreat, though. Because sometimes we equate retreat with calmness. The 40 days of Lent is anything but calm for us. It causes us for self-examination, to look deep within our own lives, and really name that area in which our lives are crippled, or as I said, has the disease of the sin of leprosy. To ask the Lord to remove it from us. But not just simply remove it from us, because in faith He will immediately do that. But there's another part of that. And that is the ongoing conversion. Jesus enjoined on them, watch out, guard against the leaven of the Pharisees and the leaven of Herod. Non-conversion, full of egoism and pride, no need to convert. They have it all made. They understand. They stand at the head of the community. It's like me saying that I have no need of Lent, have no need of confession, I have no need of conversion. It's ridiculous. It will be to my own demise. But sometimes when the ego is so inflated, we trip over our self-pride. We have to be very careful about that. So be careful of the leaven of pride. Be careful of the leaven of covetousness. lust and anger, and gluttony and envy and sloth. Be careful of them, because we become so inflated with them by our own pride that we trip and fall into serious sin. So let us together on this Shrove Tuesday, this Mardi Gras, really for Christians it's more of a Shrove Tuesday than a Mardi Gras, isn't it? The world wants to party today so that tomorrow they're ready for the rigors of fasting. But Shrove Tuesday helps us to examine our sin and the sins that we struggle with. And the sin that the Lord is placing before us for a need of serious conversion. Let us make this journey with the Lord, sure, as a retreat, because it's spiritual intensity with God. But let us also understand that this spiritual intensity helps us to awaken in us for self-examination, to root out those things that are not of God. And it will take us about 40 days to do it. And then at Easter, we can rise from that sin, and we can move on, being aware of the weak points in our life, so as not to return to that sin again. Before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For all members of the church, may the Holy Spirit strengthen us in our work of building the kingdom of God on earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For legislatures around the world, may God embolden them in enacting policies to protect human life in all stages. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are hungry or food insecure, may the love of God call forth people and resources to meet their needs. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may the Lord's compassion enable us to see and respond to one another's suffering. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may God welcome them to eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Rosemary Bowerly, Alyssa Bonavito, Roseanne Bonner, Aidan Gray, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Dennis Zachary, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us can further the mission of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially from members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, because we are released to be able to seek the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
All glory and honor is
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. O my God, my only hope, I have placed all my trust in you, and I know I shall not be disappointed.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. them of delights, we pray, O Lord, that we may always long for that food by which we truly live, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Mass is tomorrow at 9, and then 12 noon, and then 7 o'clock at night. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice day, everybody.
You too, Father.
St. Michael,
be our angel, defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God.